Flasher ATE is a gang programmer from SEGGER that allows you to program up to 10 embedded target boards in parallel. This video shows you how to set up the SEGGER Flasher ATE and start programming target boards in 6 easy steps. Step 1. Software setup. In order to set up and operate the Flasher ATE, you need the SEGGER JFlash programming software and the SEGGER JLink configurator software. These software tools are included in the JLink software and documentation pack, which is available for download from the SEGGER website. You will also need an FTP client, for example, FileZilla, a terminal program, for example, TerraTerm, and the firmware or a test program to be programmed into the target boards. Step 2. Hardware setup. Power the Flasher ATE main module via a 5-volt power supply or via USB. This also powers the connected Flasher ATE programming modules. If you intend to power the target hardware to be programmed via the Flasher ATE, and your target hardware also takes 5 volts, then no additional target power supply is needed. Otherwise, you can connect one or multiple separate 3 to 15 volt target power supplies to the programming modules. You can also self-power the targets while they are being programmed. To complete the hardware setup, connect the Flasher ATE to your network. It will attempt to acquire an IP address via DHCP. Step 3. Generating the project files in JFlash. Next, you need to generate the project files using the SEGGER JFlash software. In a later step, you will then upload these files to the Flasher ATE. After starting JFlash, create a new JFlash project for the target device by selecting File, New Project. After the project has been created, open the data file to be programmed into the target boards by selecting File, Open Data File. If your project has specific requirements, follow the instructions in the JFlash user guide to set up your project. You can find further details in Chapter 3, Getting Started, of the JFlash documentation. Now it's time to generate the project files. Select File, Save Flasher Config File to generate and save the project configuration file. Select File, Save Flasher Data File to generate and save the project data file. Step 4. Setting up the network configuration. Before you can upload the project configuration and data files to the Flasher ATE for the first time, the Flasher ATE IP settings need to be configured via the JLink Configurator tool. After starting JLink Configurator, you should see your Flasher ATE displayed in the list. Notice the IP address that was assigned to it by your network. Right-click on your Flasher ATE, choose Configure from the context menu, and enter the required IP settings. Confirm the settings by clicking OK. Please note that your computer needs to be connected to the same network as the Flasher ATE, ideally using a wired LAN connection. Step 5. Loading the project files to the Flasher ATE. Open the FileZilla FTP client and create a new connection for the Flasher ATE by choosing File, Site Manager, and entering the connection settings. The username for the FTP connection is admin, and the password is 1234. Connect to the Flasher ATE. Next, the project files need to be loaded to each of the Flasher ATE modules that shall program the target boards with this particular project. Navigate to the project files created by JFlash in Step 3. Select a module folder in the remote site view. Then select a configuration file and the data file for your project. choose Upload from the context menu to upload them to the module folder. Note that the programming modules don't need to contain the same project files. You can upload different project files to different modules. You can even upload multiple project files to each programming module. If your target device needs one or more script files, JFlash will create a folder with the same name as the config file. The folder contains the required script files indicated by the .pex file extension. If this folder exists, you need to upload this folder to the programming module as well. Repeat this step for each connected module that shall program the target boards with this particular project. Now everything is ready for programming the targets. Step 6, programming the targets. To remote control the Flasher ATE, open TerraTerm and connect to the Flasher ATE via Telnet on port 23. Adjust the terminal settings so that you can see replies from the Flasher ATE. You can check if the Flasher ATE is ready to accept commands using the command /status. First, select the project that shall be flashed by using the command /select module number project file name. Repeat this step for every module. Second, select the modules which shall be used for programming using the command /sel module, first module number, second module number, and so on. Third, start the programming with the command /auto *. The Flasher ATE will perform the programming operation and respond with the results. A list of all Flasher ATE commands is available in the Flasher ATE user manual. The Flasher ATE also comes with a built-in web server. Just type the IP address of your Flasher ATE into a web browser to access your Flasher ATE. The web server on the Flasher ATE provides you with a web interface for information and network configuration. You can see the firmware version of your main board and how many modules are connected. In the network settings, the IP address can be changed and a nickname can be assigned to the device. Additionally, the web interface provides information about the status of the main board, like supply voltage and current consumption. The ATE's web interface furthermore allows monitoring of the individual programming modules. You can see the project that is currently active in each module. You can even perform a programming operation on all targets with a single click. This video showed you how to set up the SEGGER Flasher ATE and start programming target boards in 6 easy steps. For additional information on the Flasher ATE, please visit the SEGGER website, consult the Flasher ATE user guide, or contact us. Thanks for watching!